being with us again. Brother Curtis, it's that same old voice from the internet. You be hearing, brother, but it be true, brother. Hallelujah. I thank you. I'm just excited that y'all are here. Yah is upon us.
Yes.
I'm telling you, this is the same feeling I feel when I'm around the saints. When I'm around Pastor, I feel this same feeling.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
That we can move mountains. We can do great things.
Yes.
We just got to want to. We just got to desire. Because if you don't allow the Spirit to overtake you, He ain't going to overtake you in the day of tribulation.
Ooh,
it ain't going to overtake you to lead you nowhere. You got to be overtaken. I was telling the saints, few of y'all, you know, and you know, I'm almost hesitant to say this because I know even on camera some folks don't believe. But I'm going to go as much to say this. I was praying about 2:30 early in the week. And man, what happened just about scared my pants off. But I just stayed in the midst, Brother Snow. I was praying. I stayed there. I didn't move. But I felt so much going on. There was stuff going on around me that I can't explain. When I got up the next day, I stood there and looked at the place where I was praying at. And it, nothing was, what was going on while I was praying was going on. And so I'm just trusting in Yah that you are opening up. You are showing things. You are taking me to a place where I can abide in your spirit. Whatever goes on, I can be like them of old and just be strengthened, be of just the courage of many men, no matter what happened. All the way into death. We read about Eliezer. He stood. He knew that he must tell this truth unto death, that the generations behind shall receive Yah and not miss a beat. So you got to be that dedicated. You got to be that dedicated. So when we get done with this message, it's, you know, we're going to lay hands. We're going to pray. You got to bring forth testimony.
Hallelujah.
Brother Curtis, if you and your wife don't mind coming up for a second and bring my brother up, because I prayed for him briefly, just stopping at the house.
Hallelujah.
I want y'all to hear this, man.
Hallelujah.
I want y'all to hear this. Hallelujah. Curtis, you can stand right there. You can stand right here next to him. Now, I'm standing back here talking, but I went to go visit. I called a friend because he's eating off this word. Now, you know if you have one who you share the word and he receive you not, what are you supposed to do? Dust your feet off and what? Go on to the next. All right? And so I shared a word with him. We end up at the house, them nice shoes and shirts that y'all be wearing the morning. Gay, this is where it comes from, right here.
Hallelujah.
That nice big house over there. Hallelujah. But anyway, you know, I was out there at my brother's house, and I just told him, look, brother, you know, hey, I believe in healing and laying on hands. And that, you know, things do go forth. And he said, hey, I'm with it. You know, my wife with it, so let's do it. So he was in the kitchen eating. Sharing some of his snacks with the boys. But I went over and laid hands on him, just hugged on him, and talked about the compassion of Yah.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, Yahshua. Huh? And we talked about it. Now, I didn't know what went on. I never know what's going to happen when we pray. But when we prayed, there was a testimony that came out to let me know that we need to keep praying. We need to keep going back. We need to keep seeking His face. We need to keep crying out. Now, Brother Curtis, what my man, what are we dealing with, brother?
Optic nerve hypoplasia with autism.
Gotcha. And so, when the testimony came back, what was it, Sister Brandon?
2 days after you prayed with him, we were driving home. Where were we driving home from?
The doctor's
office, and there's some construction going on outside of our house, and they have blue tarping up. And he said, Mama, look. I can see the blue curve.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
I didn't even know that it happened.
Hallelujah.
I'm just going for it. What I'm saying. And I see, I feel the same thing. It's more healing today, brother.
Hallelujah.
Studying this subject right here, I have found that people do not believe in this book. This book is a disgrace. The holy people are a disgrace. This way is a disgrace. See, this is why your life is going to be on the line. This is why some of you shall be beheaded for the testimony. Y'all hear?
Yes, sir.
See, we're talking about today is knowing what the knowledge of truth is. That's what we're talking about. See, so many people said, when I came into the knowledge of the truth. Did you really? But see, we talked about it out of Hebrews 6 and 4 today, my brother. And it's more to just coming into the knowledge of the truth. It's many parts. Once you come into it, then it's a whole experience that come with it that people don't get. Now, we're not going to be long, but we want to lay some things out. Because I want to get to this laying on the hand, let the Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Y'all, I'm telling you. I'm listening. Brothers, you know, I listen. So you can't, don't make it up. Just do your part. I prayed and walked away. I ain't asked no questions. I ain't been called. Is he healed yet? Is he, I ain't called him wearing them folks. This is the first time me hearing us, right here. Y'all better, you better get on board. It's real, my sister. The Father is real. It's a throne up there, and he's ruling and reigning on it. You understand? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So you ain't going to keep me separated from that love, brother. I know, because that's the only thing that brings people out. You got to remember, boy, you done committed sin upon sin. And now the Father has brought us somewhere. So this message is for, you know, new folks, even folks like us who have been here, who has heard this before, but not really heard it. You heard the words, but your actions ain't show that you really heard. All right? Well, let us start off by saying that we intend to find out why we all departed from our religious upbringings to walk a path unknown to us priests. All right? That's what it is. That's what this is about. Because we all walked a path previously. I asked that question today on purpose, intending to set it up. And then I also sent out some scripts. Did you get those scriptures, Brother Mark?
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I got them.
Because that is something we're going to talk about in the men's group when we have it. And then that is something that I want the sisters to talk about, because this is a question. This is a question concerning the Spirit, concerning the things of the Spirit. Because what you got to understand, there is nothing you can do, Mother, right now, physically, to make God want you. Everything it is, it's all being obedient to the Spirit that is put within you. And that does righteousness without fail. That Spirit do righteousness when you don't want to do it. You understand? And so that is where we at, because there is a path, there's only one, and there's a place where we're going. Alright? Alright, we're going to start right here in John 8:32 in the KJV. Let's go, Brother McGill.
And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
It said, and ye shall know the truth. You. Just for a purpose. See, everything starts right here by knowing the truth. Okay? And knowing the truth do what, Brother Steve-O?
Set you free.
It sets you free. That's why the ways of righteousness and being on the path causes peace. Because now that you know the truth, then you ain't got to live a lie or go around struggling not knowing what is going on around you. I know when I first came to the knowledge of truth, guess what? I went through a million types of emotions. I was happy, sad, happy, pissed off, glad, frowning, half smiling. I mean, just, I went through everything till I came to the knowledge that, you know what? Now I gotta let y'all do what he said he gonna do, because I see it. It's some talk in this word where when you see why the Messiah was really sent, we're gonna look at what Christianity said, then we're gonna see what it wrote in the book, right in the book. And only guess what? His holy people gonna be able to understand this. You understand?
Yes, sir.
All right. Saints, in finding out the truth, we would dispel a lot of things that was taught to us that wasn't necessarily truth. Today's message is about touching a few areas of truth for new people who may have recently found out that they are the chosen. Did you find out you're chosen? Did you know you're chosen? You are. See, you wouldn't be able to hear. Because remember, he said these people cannot hear. They are hard of hearing. They have ears, but can't hear. They have eyes, but can't see.
That's right.
You look and saw your dad. So that means that Yah is open and available to you.
Hallelujah.
Same with y'all, my brother. See, I didn't know who in my family. I prayed 2 weeks before, prior. I'm like, man, I'm seeing all this healing and all this stuff going on. Where my family at, Father? Is anybody going here? Then, boom, I get on Facebook. Cousin. And I was trying to talk around it. She just says, yeah, so what you doing on the Saturday? On Saturday, what? I forgot how to message when she just came right out. I showed my wife, hey, you know this ain't real. You think she know about the Saturday? I said, wow. Then I talked to her. She's like, yeah, your cousin. I said, Nick. Wait a minute. There it is. In the same time frame, one of my nieces called me crying. Would send me a message. Marco Polo crying, just boo-hooing. I know what you're doing is right.
Hallelujah.
I can't run no more. Y'all hear me?
Yes, sir.
All right. The encoding on the truth. Now, we get ready to break this down. It's John 8:36 through 44. Because there are some things in there. All right. Number one, before we read it, I want to read this statement. Yah is a spirit. And his word that was given from the beginning should be able to rest upon those in each generation who is what?
Of him.
But Satan has caused many to miss the plain truth that's right before our eyes. Y'all hear that?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's read. Where are we at, Brother Snow? You got it?
Yes, sir. If the Son, therefore, shall make you free, you shall be free indeed.
Now stop. We got to read this slow. Because there's things that you just read over.
Yes, sir.
Sit your butt still. Mm-hmm. Listen to what he said. He said, if the Son, is he talking about the Son, yellow, bright Son? What are we talking about? Read it again, Brother Snow.
If the Son, therefore, shall make you free, you shall be free indeed.
If he make you free, you shall be what?
Free indeed.
Come on, brother.
I know that you are Abraham's seed, but ye seek to kill me.
Stop. Because... Stop. Now, you know he's talking to who? He's talking to Israel. I know that you be Abraham's seed. See, that's a distinction. But why do you seek to what? Come on. Keep reading.
Because my word has no place in you. I speak that which I have seen with my Father. And ye do that which ye have seen with your father.
Now stop. He used two key words that's characteristic. Look at this. Of Hebrew nature. That's concrete. He said, you do. He said, I do that which I have what?
Seen
of my father. You do that which you have what?
Seen.
See, we know the word in Hebrew has to do with the senses. when you discern through your senses. See, this is why people can't get with what this is. See, y'all was showing me that as plain as we live, coming out here to the country. All right? All these black people just all of a sudden showed up out here, and these people wondered. Like the guy, the EMS that came to see Gabby, to see if she was all right. They like, I got to ask, what bring you guys out here? I know it. We out here, hey. Why? Because we choose to come to a place to be set apart. We ain't worried about people. We ain't here for people. We ain't here against people. We just here for y'all. Right?
Yes, sir.
So, in other people's eyes, they don't understand. They're like, great. He see us, he rides the track to cut his grass. He's like, wow, they really have a church at my house on Saturday. I let them in. Yeah, we have a church, brother. Hallelujah. Finish reading.
They answered and said unto him, Abraham is our father. Jesus said unto them, if you are Abraham's children, you would do the works of Abraham. But now you seek to kill me, a man that had told you the truth, which I have heard of. Yeah, this did not Abraham. Ye do the deeds of your father. Then they said to him, we be not born of fornication. We have one father, even Yah. Jesus said unto them, if Yah were your father, you would love me. For I proceeded forth and came from Yah. Neither came I myself, but he sent me. Why do you not understand my speech? Even because ye cannot hear my word? Ye are of your father, the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaks of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it.
Now, it's just as simple as this. Look, if y'all really get what I'm finna say, we can shut this down and be done. I said, if. But I know you ain't. Because it take us a long time. You guys, this word is, it's so much, look. What do it say up there first, Brother McKay? What do it say?
Yeshua spoke life in those passages in John. And because many believed lies, Satan convinced them to deny the truth, as we do today.
Now you hear this? See, they was convinced in being believers of the lies that their father was telling. That's what they didn't understand what Yeshua was saying. See, because remember I said last week, we don't realize that Satan is operating in us because when we go to the mirror, who we see? Ourselves. Right? You don't see no man standing there with a pitchfork and horns out his ear. So you don't think Satan is around you. You don't think he's operating in you. Right? So Yeshua is telling them something real defined. We're finna find out a few things. We're just gonna point out a few things about this passage. All right. Key point number one. Verse 39 said, they answered and said unto him, Abraham is what?
Our father.
According to the what?
Flesh.
Now remember that. He's our father according to the what?
Flesh.
According to the flesh. Jesus said unto them, if ye were Abraham's children, ye would do the works of who?
Abraham.
Now you got to understand. See, he said something powerful in that. See, even there, people claim Abraham, but yet there's a promise. Even to the Holy Spirit was a promise unto his seed. But people just want to be associated with the flesh, and so therefore you want to go and try to learn, you know, this language. You want to try to go do this. Now, I didn't say nothing was wrong with learning that language. That's not what I said. Do it sound like what I said?
No, sir.
Listen to what I'm saying. I'm trying to keep you from burning yourself by trusting in earthly things. Trusting in the things that's below. That's why the Pharisees and the Sadducees didn't understand when Jesus said, before Abraham was, I am. They couldn't see that because that was on another spiritual plane. Only because you were looking straight here to Abraham had been born. You was born after. How could you be? You know, you was off. All right? So here, let's take this verse. Let's flip over. Now, Abraham, G11, Strong's Dictionary of Hebrew Origin. Abraham, the what?
Amen.
Hebrew patriarch. Now we gotta pay attention. You can't erase that. He the what?
Hebrew patriarch.
Cause I'm getting there. How many Christians we got in this room? Boy, y'all better not raise your hands. You better not. Boy, glue it in your pocket. You heard? You see what it said? Abraham is the what?
Hebrew
patriarch. Hallelujah. The origin is from Hebrew 85. Abraham, a friend of Yah and founder of what?
Hebrew nation.
He's one of the founders of the Hebrew nation via Yah's what?
Elective covenant.
That's where it is. Yah's elective covenant. This is what it is. See, you can't get around that. You can't get around. This is why. So what I'm telling you right now, and what we're gonna begin to look at next in Christianity, it's a space, it's a gap in there, just like we live. We live the gap without Yah, though he manifests himself because he wanted us. He was desiring us. And when we start desiring him, then he starts showing himself, then guess what? We ended up where we at right now. Not just somebody just came and told you something, and then you all of a sudden you leave for this cult. No, people don't understand. Right?
Right.
Key point number two. What did it say?
Satan was a murderer from the beginning.
Let's see. Y'all tell him something deep. You sure would tell him something deep? He said Satan was a what?
Murderer.
From when?
From the beginning.
Satan like drawing blood. Because the blood leave out your body, what happened?
You die.
Die. The life is gone. The life spills out. That's why in Revelation it says in the blood. Right? From those who have been slain on earth. They cried out. Asking Yah, how long yet will you avenge us? Of the blood that was shed. Wait yet, my servant, a little while longer until those who are on earth be beheaded. You hear that? What cried out? They what?
Their blood.
The commandment says, you shall not shed what?
Blood.
Now watch this. So you think I put this picture up here because you think knife and shed is some blood. You think right now this, see, this look like murder, don't that's what you associate with something. Died. Did you get that? When y'all seen that picture, did that come to mind?
Yes.
That something died, right?
Yes,
and so it looked like, well, what else can we assume? We see a knife, then they must have died by what?
Somebody stabbed them,
right? Yeah. But watch this. Satan didn't stab Adam and Eve.
No, sir.
He spoke something to them and caused them to die and kill them. He killed him with lies. Therefore, what he spoke to him, remember we was down in Tabernacles and we read that verse out of Isaiah and it talked about speaking villainy. When people speak villainy, they dry up your water. Right? And when your water dry up, then you die spiritually because now you no longer have anything to keep you going. The wellspring of life is no longer springing up in you. No more. Therefore, you suffer a death. We talk about the end. That people shall die a what?
Second
death. Right? So you got to understand what we're talking about. Let's go here in Genesis chapter 3, verse 2 through 5. You got it, brother?
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Listen to this. Listen.
Come on. And the woman said to the serpent, we are to eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden. But of the fruit of the tree, which is in the midst of the garden, Yah has said, do not eat of it.
Now stop. She had the word of truth in her. You hear this? So that means that if you got the word of truth operating, then that means that you have knowledge what?
Of the truth.
You got knowledge of the truth. Y'all hear me?
Yes, sir.
Y'all remember what we talking about, right? The knowledge of the truth. She had the knowledge of the truth. Now watch the murderer who was from the beginning. Watch him come along. Let's go, brother.
And the serpent said to the woman, you shall certainly not die. For Yah knows that in the day you eat of it, your eyes shall be opened, and you shall be like him.
Now stop.
See what you did to me? You fed me perversion. You told me I wasn't going to die, knowing that when I do it, I'm going to what?
Die.
You see this? See, and what we talking about is word. We talking about, see, y'all missed it. Y'all missed it. That's why I said we missed it. We talking about commandment versus the word of somebody else other than y'all. And this is the problem we dealing with right now. This is why you in here. And that's why they not in here. Because they going by somebody else's word. You going by y'all's word. He said, remember the Sabbath day, what?
Keep it holy.
That's why you in here. Because you have knowledge of the truth. She had knowledge of the truth, but look, Satan been doing, he ain't no new thing, so he been doing what Luke Abram, it warns you about this. That soon as the knowledge of the truth come in, then here comes Satan, come to steal the seed out, the word of truth out of your heart. Come on.
For he knows that in the day that you eat of it, your eyes shall be open, and you shall be like him, knowing good and evil.
Is that it?
Yep.
Right. Y'all got it?
Yes, sir.
Now, in that, she ate of it. Then she took it to her husband to eat of it. Their eyes was open, and they ultimately did what? Died. Now, did they die from a knife?
No, sir.
What they die from? The words that were spoke, the lies. So that means people can remember the in James said the tongue is an evil. It's a deadly poison. The tongue. The tongue, brother. This is what I be saying about you gotta be real careful who's speaking Hebrew Israelite to you. If you don't, they're gonna speak deaf to you. It's gonna sound like and look like. It sounds like what y'all said. The difference is, brother, it's powerful. You heard a testimony. Right? So we gotta be doing something. Well, these testimonies just keep stacking up like this. Boom, boom, boom. We gotta be on path, but yet somebody will come tell you that you're jumping to where they off. I just try to tell you, Daniel, they off over there. They good people. But they off, they gonna go to hell. Because they doctor over there, they speaking in tongues. This speech done, it's box is what they doing.
Okay.
Yep. Sister Sandra is interpreting Bacchus, and Sister Jasmine Roberts is interpreting Bacchus. And, yep.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Yep.
Oh boy. Come on. Yo. So the whole nature of beguiling you, now that word beguile, you hear me? Is to draw you from, to deceive, to cover up, until, you hear that? To hide it until, brother Bud, till you walk past, then uncover it again. So the whole nature of beguiling you is to get you to exalt what? Your knowledge above the knowledge of what? Turning from the what? To a lie. Turning from the truth to a lie. Alright? Now, watch this. Ancient Israel denies the Sabbath. Why? Because they could not receive the truth because of what was in. The only reason why stuff don't go in when you tell people the truth is because of what's in them. See, watch this. I can turn around and tell Jay, you beautiful. Do you believe that? You don't believe you beautiful?
She's like, oh, I don't know. I'm that baby down.
I can tell a baby something, and they're going to look. She's pondering, trying to wonder. I can tell Gabe, I'm going to give you a dollar after Sabbath. Do you want a dollar? You don't? Okay, you don't. You want one, bro? You can tell these babies something and they will receive it, but you tell one of these hard-headed adults, nappy head, lines, breath stink.
You tell them something, but they ain't gonna receive nothing. They just think you lie everything you're saying. Mm-hmm. All because what happened to them. Right? Let's go to Hebrews 4, verse 2. Watch this. I want y'all to listen to this. Because see, this is the problem. This is why people miss it. Alright? Let's go, Brother Snow.
For unto us was the gospel preached.
Now listen, listen. It says, for unto who?
Us
was the gospel preached. Go ahead.
As well as unto them.
As well as unto them. Come on.
But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it.
You hear me? See, it didn't profit them, not being mixed with what?
Faith.
You see what I'm saying? So this is what's got to happen. Because now this is going to come down to a divide. And this is what we're going to look at today. We're going to look at the divide that's going to come upon us. That we're going to have to operate and understand. We can't receive truth because we have received the lie of the enemy. Therefore, those who deny the commandments are liars and are not of the covenant of our Father. Now, you hear that? So now, quit trying to make people be brothers and sisters. Quit trying to make them be believers. They not. They're only believers by way of outer speech and admonition. So in essence, the knowledge of truth is having a working knowledge of what God desires, right? Didn't Eve have a working knowledge? Right? Having a working knowledge of what y'all desires, look, in the word of his bride. See, he got in his word, he got what he desires of us as brides. Does that make sense? Does that make sense, Brother Curtis? Because you know, in the end, you're going to go to the wedding feast, right?
That's right.
That's where we're supposed to go, right? Is this, we say all of this, we're going to the wedding feast. So that means that you shall show up as a bride. Now, what if we was like tradition, we stand ready to get married, right? And your wife came walking up there with one of them things, you know they wear it with only the little thing around her leg, and then a little string, and all she had was a bra and underwear, but she came walking up there. Huh? Is that what you waiting on? No, Christ ain't waiting on nothing like that. Depart from me, I never knew you. Right? And that's what we're talking about. So look, let's dispel the myth. Now let's look at this picture real deep. What do we see? What do you see, Brother Miguel?
I see a bunch of things.
It's a bunch, eh?
Yeah,
one big man with a head.
A mule.
You got a monster up behind it. See, look, this is how people feed. This is what religion is right here. It's like, what is it? All it? It's all this stuff. That people, you ain't supposed to be doing that. You ain't supposed to be. Because I'm going to show you. I took a bunch of different quotes on what people thought Christianity was. And we're going to see all this different stuff. But clearly in the word, it's going to tell us why the Messiah came. It's going to tell us clearly what it is. See, now, for me, Brother Carl, I can believe it because I've experienced the power. Like I was talking about, what's his name? So now, I'm not going to let nobody come tell me that Christianity is fake. You're right. I'm an Israelite. You know what I'm saying? You right. Well, that's fake to all of Abrahamic religions. Like Ray Hayden's. Dude, you must ain't seen no power. Curtis, I didn't pay y'all to come here and pay. Hey, when y'all come today, tell people your son got healed. I'm going to give you $600, brother. Just tell them. Somebody told me that the pastor was paying people out on the side of the church, and they would come in and act like they got healed. I was talking to somebody this week. I said, come on now. You see what I'm saying? And you would never get to this point, brother. Let's go, Josh. All right. We're going to look at the truth or the lies associated with
Christianity, another Jesus, Israelites, and the body of Yahshua. Now we can ready to roll. This message ain't long, because this is mainly just presenting truth. And some of us need a refresher. Let's dive over into Christianity. All right? Let's roll. All right. Let's go, Brother McGill.
Christianity. To some, it means you were born in a Christian nation, or you come from a Christian family.
Now pause. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
That was true, but because remember I told y'all the story? We riding back, me and one of my homeboys riding back on 50. We stacked up with Bud. Matter of fact, I don't know, I think I was talking about Tory one day, and then he called while we was up in the dining hall. It was just wild how he called right at that instant. But we riding back Highway 50, we blowed out. Got weed all up and down the legs, in the trunk, under the seats, everywhere you can have in the car. So we can come back, and we were doing our thing. And police pulls us up. We get pulled over, and we like, let the window down, smoke going out. High blown, nervous. You gentlemen all right? Yes, sir. He turned and looked straight ahead. He looked at us. Your tail lights out. You gentlemen have a good day. I looked at T like, we just sat there. The police drove off. We just sitting there, man, about 30 minutes quiet. Like, then the first thing Kelly Mike said, he said, CP. What's up, cuz? You believe in God? Yup. He said, man, I'm a Christian. And me too. See what I'm saying? So look, you only a Christian cause by designation. Because you was born in a Christian nation. And what? You come from a Christian what?
Family.
So we was Christians.
Yes, sir.
And that's how far it went. We Christians in the car, blowed out, getting ready to go with the intent to go distribute. You know what I mean? Here it is. We never talked about it. It took us about to go to jail and realize, hey, we Christians. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man.
Yes, sir.
That can't be it, right? Ain't no way. I'm finished reading it, brother.
To others, it means you believe in Jesus or the religion that is based on Jesus' teachings. Yet, others use the word Christian to speak of a deep personal relationship between Jesus Christ and an individual.
Now, Paul, see, even that whole statement is jacked up. Brother Mark, you know why? Because they said they believe in Jesus or believe in Jesus' teaching, but Jesus said, I came to do what? My Father's will. Right?
That's right.
He that believes on me, believes on who?
Yeah.
See what I'm saying? So we missing the whole point. That's how, look, it's the same thing with the tree. You ain't gonna die. But he know that if you eat from the tree, you're gonna become like him, having knowledge of good and evil. And so then we just go along with this old Christianity, with all the lunch pails. Going to church on Sunday. Taking all these Easter pictures. Boy, it gets ridiculous too, don't it? Some of the women have to be this big, don't it? Big and pink, don't it? Won't make no sense. But it's foolishness. Alright, let's go. Alright, now, here's what the world says Christianity is. So we can already read. Alright, this is right off the internet. So I ain't touching. All I'm gonna cut, look. Screenshot, and I put it right there. I ain't touching. Right here for y'all. Boom. You got what you want. All right. Let's go. Let's read this person, Brother Snow.
The Council of Jerusalem, Apostolic Council, was held in Jerusalem around 50 AD. It is unique among the ancient pre-ecumenical councils in that it is considered by Catholics and Orthodox to be a prototype and forerunner of the later ecumenical councils and the key part of the Christian ethics. The council decided that Gentile converts to Christianity were not obligated to keep most of the law.
Come on.
Of Moses, including the rules concerning circumcision of males. The council did, however, retain the prohibitions on eating blood, meat containing blood, and meat of animals not properly slain, and on fornication and idolatry, sometimes referred to as the Apostolic Decree or Jerusalem Quadrilateral.
All right, now, would y'all listen to me? Because in that study, had y'all forsook the law, we went over this. When Paul went up to the Council of Jerusalem, or he went and seen Peter and the other elders, and they said, it seemed right to us and to the what? Holy Spirit. That we put no more burdens on them than these, because they were new coming in. And you see, even after that, Paul, he taught in the synagogues, he taught Moses. You see, he told Timothy after that to continue in the scriptures or the sacred texts. Why would Paul tell you continue in the law which you had come up if I ain't supposed to be teaching no more? We ain't going to put the law in. We ain't going to put no law on. Well, that's what this is saying. See, this is why these folks is off. See, ain't no power. This is just information. And if you're looking for Christianity, then you come and you find this, then you think you're in the clear. And you ain't going to go look at what eating blood is or meat containing blood. You ain't going to look at it. Even that has a whole thing concerning blood in the law. But yet, it's just like Satan did. Here it is. Y'all looking at it. They give you this, what Satan told Eve, they give you this version. So you can live by this stuff instead of listening. Because we're going to listen to some stuff here, and we're going to read. I ain't going to have to make no commentary. It's just going to be powerful. It's going to say what it's going to say. And you understand, those of you all who are filled with this spirit. All right? Let's go, Brother McGill.
Christianity is an Abrahamic religion that began as a second temple Judaic sect in the mid-first century.
Now stop. It said Christianity did what? When did it begin?
Second temple
in the mid-first century.
Now watch this. But the faith been gone.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying? See, people ain't paying attention. You missed it. You're like, wow, that's when it started. Wow. But you ain't thinking like I am. I know this is an ongoing issue that Yah has come to redeem his people, because his people that has been going through this stuff for a long time. And this is a act by his hand to teach them, and after the lesson is learned, then redeem them.
Hallelujah.
So it ain't just start right here. See what I'm saying? You got to dispel stuff so you don't get caught up. Quit just listening to stuff. CJ, I got a bowl of cereal under your seat. See what I'm saying? Just tell them something. He started looking. Right? Come on, brother. Finish reading.
Originating in Judea, it quickly spread to Europe, Syria, Mesopotamia, Asia Minor, Transcaucasia, Egypt, Ethiopia, and India. And by the end of the 4th century, had become the official state church of the Roman Empire.
And had become the official what?
State church.
Of what?
The Roman Empire.
So ain't got nothing to do with Israelite.
Not at all.
Nothing. You see this? Ain't got nothing to do with what it was for. See, wait till we get to this, sister. This is what's going to hit you in the head. You're going to remember this all the way down to Dallas. You're going to be like, wow. Because ain't nothing but field and trees, so ain't nothing down there. You're going to be thinking about this all the way home. All right? Let's go.
Following the age of discovery.
Go ahead.
Following the age of discovery, Christianity spread to the Americas, Australasia, Sub-Saharan Africa, and the rest of the world through mission and colonization. Christianity has played a prominent role in the shaping of Western civilization.
Now see, this is what it is. Now what you got to realize what they're talking about here. See, the Messiah came to do what he did, and he knew, just like sin was a seed, the seed of righteousness had been planted also. So now those who in the last times would receive that seed of righteousness, and you would spring up. Just like all of this wickedness. This is why this ain't, it ain't no power. How can you be Roman Catholic, you be the Pope, and you say that God has talked to you and told you that he's no longer concerned with homosexuals? And he's scratching it out. Oh, yeah. You didn't know that? But the book said whoever take away. So that's y'all too, right?
Yes.
And whoever add too. Come on. Come on. Let's go. See, this is why you have to be careful, because many people speak about things they have not discerned in the word of Yah. You got to be careful. Now, let's get down to it. Let us who are in the house of Israel first discern what our faith is about. Now, we're going to get to this. This is cold. I love this. I can't wait till y'all hear this in y'all ear. You got to hear. You got to hear. Let me ask my question. Let me ask. Who in here is Israel? Raise your hand. Hallelujah. All right. Yeah, y'all Israel. You don't think you are, but you are. You don't know it. Who over there are the children? If you Israel, raise your hand.
Hallelujah.
All right. No sodomites, right? No. Everybody say no.
No.
All right. Hallelujah. Sodomites is what they do when they have man lying with man, and the world agree with it, and they pass the law that they can do it. That's what it is. That a man can marry a man. All right? That's wicked, ain't it? Is it wicked, ain't it? Hallelujah. Give her a hand. I mean, hallelujah. I mean, because they soft you up. They soft you up. See, this is what I want you to understand. I don't have a problem with people who's gay. You know why? Because words say, them without, judge what? Judge not. I don't have no problem with what you're doing. But you ain't finna put that on my chill, because we're going to have a problem.
That's
we're going to have a problem. You ain't finna bring that. That's why we doing what we do. That's why the nation has to be restored. This is what it's about. Only way you're going to be able to practice righteousness if you get together and practice it. That's why the disciples got together in Acts 2.
That's right.
And sold everything they had, and they got together. They broke bread and continued in prayer and signs and wonders daily. You got it?
Yes, sir.
That's why they did it. Because there wasn't many people around after the crucifixion of the Messiah. They worried about it. Hey, he was just like everybody else. He was gone now. Unless we go forth and show forth signs, because guess what, Curtis? That changed, hey, that made you think when your son said that. He saw me, he's like, you know what? I don't know who this dude is, but we're going to keep on. We got to check him out some more.
Amen.
And guess what I'm pointing you to?
Hallelujah.
I ain't do nothing, bro. I ain't taking no credit. Zero. We're going to keep letting Jesus do the healing.
Hallelujah.
Y'all hear me?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Y'all ready to hear this?
Yes, sir.
Cause we can bust that bubble. Y'all remember the stuff that was up there, right? We was all over the place. And Council of Jerusalem. We was all over the place. Right? Watch this. Where we at? Let's go, Brother Snow.
Blessed be Yahweh Elohim of Israel.
Now wait, we got to take our time with this. Yes. Blessed be who?
Yahweh Elohim.
Blessed be Yahweh Elohim of who?
Israel.
Of Christianity.
Israel.
Of Israel. Let's go, brother.
For he had visited and redeemed his people.
Now wait a minute. Y'all visited his people?
Yes, sir.
Y'all did?
Yes, sir.
But I thought Jesus did. Oh, you hear this lie that people be saying? Do you hear it, brothers? He has done what? Come on, finish read.
And have raised up a horn of salvation.
And now look, and have raised up a horn of salvation. Come on.
For us in the house of his servant David.
Now look, for who?
Us.
For who?
Us.
That's in what? Now, you gotta say it. That's in the house of David. Because look, we're going to see in the word somewhere where it's going to say that a servant doeth not remain in the house of his master forever, but a son abides forever. Now, you understand what he's saying? See, we're going to touch that. See, this is important stuff. This is important stuff. See, this is why we don't get mixed up. Because remember, if you are only sons and daughters according to the flesh, then you what? You're none of Elohim. See what I'm saying? If you are only a son and daughter according to the flesh, what I said, people be saying they can fellowship with whoever they say is Israel. Well, we just the general body. Everybody's Israel. So we just going to fellowship with everybody. Well, go ahead then. Because Christ already spoke. Go ahead and go over his head. Finish reading. Let's go.
As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets.
Now, as he spake by who?
The mouth.
Who spoke?
Yah.
Remember, look. Yah spoke by who?
The mouth.
So he spoke, you mean tell me he spoke by some flesh people, Brother Chris? Why would he speak by some flesh people? You mean, so Yah came down himself and spoke to us? Who he came to say, read it again.
As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophet.
Y'all hear that? See that? What did he do, Brother Chris?
He spoke by the mouth of his holy prophet.
See that? He spoke by the mouth of his holy prophet. That's what you don't realize. Because y'all be looking at people in flesh. So you looking at Pastor Corey standing up here. Look at him. He fake. He ain't real. Ain't no pastor. Stand up there, dread guy, everybody sitting down. They should be studying. It said that you sit at the seat of the Holy Spirit. You're supposed to sit at the seat of men. What that say to that? Mm-hmm. Yeah, Brother Curtis, I came over there and just was obedient. I was sitting there on the couch. The Father said, lay hands on him to show them the power of Yah. So I did. I didn't know what happened. Then it came back. It had fruit. So that's what? You ain't supposed to know me by nothing else. Don't know me by working at UPS. Know me by their fruit. Y'all see what's going on? Come on, man. We talking. Finish reading. Listen to this, Luke, because we getting to it.
Which have been since the world began.
Look, which has been since the world began. So he talked. Now look, this is the New Testament. He telling them something that was important because the prophets spoke about the Messiah, which they spoke since the be what?
The beginning.
What he spoke is what he spoke from the beginning. Just like it said in Peter. He said, I speak to you no new thing, but I speak to you that which was from what?
The beginning.
And he was talking about the commandments in the New Testament. This is what Peter said. But everybody getting on Peter. They getting on us. Calling us a cult because this is what we saying. But Peter said, get on Peter. Get on Peter. We going to get on Peter. Right? Jesus. Come on, brother.
That we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us.
Now look. Look what he's talking about. See, all of this makes sense. It said that we should be saved from our enemies and all that hate us. This right here in the New Testament. See, it's talking some powerful stuff. See, because this is a nation. This is a house that we in. That only the people inside is going to be affected. Let's go. Finish reading.
To perform the mercy promised to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant, the oath which he swore to our father Abraham, that he would grant unto us that we being delivered out of the hand of our enemies might serve him without fear and holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our life. And thou, child, shalt be called the prophet of the highest. For thou shalt go before the face of Yahweh to prepare his ways, to give knowledge of salvation unto his people by remission of their sins through the tender mercy of our Elohim, whereby the day spring from on high have visited us, to give light to them that sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. And the child grew and waxed strong in spirit and was in the deserts to the day of his showing unto Israel.
Now look, Christ stayed in the desert until his showing to all the nations that is upon the earth. Who did it say? He stayed in the desert until the day of showing to who?
Israel.
We missed that. And he said that he was a part of the promise to his people to bring forth the mercy that was promised. See, they recognized it was for us. So how can people begin to separate themselves and come with all this other stuff, the Roman Catholicism, and man, this stuff then went south. Now all of a sudden, God then changed his mind and told you he ain't concerned with homosexuals no more? That ain't the covenant. It's just like Satan did with Eve in the beginning. returning to the truth. We returning to it because somebody has stole it out of the ears of our parents. They stole it out of the hearts of our grandparents. They just stole it from our generations. Now we returning to it, and you can clearly hear it. This ain't saying nothing about Christianity. None of the stuff that we say it is. Ain't no Christmas in that. Ain't none of that junk in this. This is clearly about Yah redeeming his people from the hand of his enemies. This is clearly about his people being restored. This is clearly about them receiving the promise that he had gave through the covenant that he made with Abraham. That's what Jesus was talking to these people in flesh and blood. Yet, y'all, they can't hear what he's saying. He hears salvation standing in front of them. Talking and speaking the word of truth, but yet you can't receive him because you believe a lie. Mm-hmm. That's why people can't receive you when you take the commandments, because they believe a what?
A lie.
Y'all say he's going to send a strong delusion upon them that they believe a what?
A lie.
Y'all hear it? Mm-hmm. See, ain't nothing changed. Ain't nothing changed. We just got to stay focused on what Yah is doing before our eyes. Alright? Now, what did Yahshua say in Matthew 15:24? Alright, it's right up here. Let's go.
But he answered her not a word, and his disciples came and besought him, saying, send her away, for she cried afterwards.
Now, he was talking about this lady who came. She was a Canaanite woman, and in that day, Canaanite women didn't associate with Israelite women, Israelite men. They separate. So the disciples saying, send her away, for she crieth after us. And then the Messiah being meek and humble and being the nice and kind man that he is, he decided not to speak to this woman, bud. Now, how you being kind, bud? If I speak to you, bud, speak to me. Right? You, Jesus, you're supposed to speak to me. Jesus ain't supposed not to speak to people. Jesus is supposed to heal everybody. Right? But watch this. He didn't see him. He didn't answer. He didn't say nothing to him. Now, here we go. Read 25.
And he answered, saying, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Y'all hear that? Now, who did Jesus say he was sent to? Didn't Luke just get through saying this? That he was the promise that was came? Then Jesus came right behind. The Father said, out of the mouth of who? Two or what? Three witnesses. So shall what? A thing be established. So how you going to reestablish it? Well, I know he was, but where is the but in the word? Show it to me. Because you got to join to the covenant. Salvation is unto the Yahudim first, then to who? To the Gentiles. You can't go change Yah's word because you want to. So then, in other words, look what they're doing. They preaching us a what?
Jesus.
Look at them. Got the Masonic sign up. Now, let's analyze this picture. What color is his eyes?
Blue.
What color is his skin?
Brown.
What color is his hair?
Brown.
Right? All of this stuff right here is what you done fed me. Now, I was telling somebody last week. Me, Sister Gabby, Brother Chris, Sister Jalon, JC, Miracle, CJ, Isaiah, Josh. Y'all miss somebody? Just what was just born. We went to World Revival. Now, what type of church is that, Brother Chris?
I mean, they worship and praise. It was on point. We seen healing. But at the same time, it's a non-denominational church. And their belief in Israel was totally different than us in there. Like, he was deceived in the ones over there in Jerusalem opposed, and we're sitting right there amongst your congregation.
Now, this was Steve Gray wanted to make a movie in Israel. And we went there, and we had a problem. And on top of that, we were some of the few black people that went there. Their church was all white. Did you have a problem?
No, sir.
I didn't either. I was there every week. Dun, 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 dun. Right? Having a ball.
Right.
I didn't care what you thought about me. Because I felt like we praising Jesus.
Yeah.
Right? But then, you didn't tell me. Y'all ready? Let's go. Watch this. Now, let's look at Yahshua in the Word. We're going to get there. Here it is. One pull up one pull up the next. Now, let's do it. Look, it's right here, Brother Curtis. Look, everything is right here. You ain't got to ask me. I'm going to get off the camera. At this point, you will only hear my voice. Are you ready, Brother Miguel? Which one you got? Snow got it?
Yes, sir.
All right, Ezekiel 40, verse 1 through 4.
In the 520th year of our captivity, in the beginning of the year, in the 10th day of the month, in the 14th year after that, the city was smitten, in the selfsame day, the hand of Yah was upon me and brought me thither. And the visions of Yah brought he me into the land of Israel.
Now pause. Remember, in Luke, it said that in times past, Yah had spoke by the mouth of who? Man, he began to show him. So now look. They had already spoke about the Messiah that was coming. Here's a vision of Yah showing Ezekiel the Messiah standing on the mount in the city. Here's a vision of him showing him the Messiah. So if I want to know about the Messiah, let me read this and see what he said. Come on, read.
And set me upon a very high mountain, by which was as the frame of a city on the south. And he brought me thither, and behold, there was a man whose appearance was like the appearance of brass.
Wait a minute. He said appearance, bud. You hear that? You hear him say appearance? Read that again, bro.
And he brought me thither, and behold, there was a man whose appearance was like the appearance.
Wait a minute. He said appearance. I'm trying to figure out why he said appearance. That's what he looked like. Right? Come on.
Whose appearance was like the appearance of brass, with a line of flax in his hand, and a measuring reed, and he stood in the gate. And the man said unto me, Son of man, behold with thine eyes, and hear with thine ears, and set thine heart upon all that I shall show thee. For the intent that I might show them unto thee, art thou brought hither. Declare all that thou seest to the house of Israel.
And he said declare to who? Christians, right?
House of Israel.
Because the whole thing is that's been going on, Brother Bud, is for Yah to provide hope for his people, knowing that people are going to present this picture to us, which is a graven image. Because we shouldn't even have no images.
That's right.
So what happens is, in graven image, we end up worshiping an image that ain't had nothing to do with salvation.
That's right.
That's what it comes down to. See, it ain't got nothing to do with people, but you painted a graven image to associate with people that you won't worship.
Yes,
opposed to worshiping the one whom we had not seen. We ain't seen him.
Yes, sir.
So if I want to know how he looked, then guess what? This gave me a brief description.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Daniel 10, 5 through 6.
Then I lifted my eyes and looked, and saw a certain man dressed in linen, whose loins were girded with gold of Uphaz, and his body was like beryl, and his face like the appearance of lightning, and his eyes like torches of fire, and his arms and feet like polished bronze in appearance.
Now stop. Look at this. And his arms and feet. Talk about his skin. See this? Here we go again. But I had never heard this until I came into the truth. Because see, we talking about something. What it comes down to when you come into the knowledge of truth, that you got to bring all of these people together. And we got to come under the banner of truth and be ready to be persecuted. No matter what, we got to tell people the truth. Don't lie. Don't sit there and agree with people that they're lying to you about what it is. You brought out just for this. You got to be the light.
Right.
You got to be the salt of the earth. How you going to be the salt of the earth and you still set me alive? Well, I just can't believe Ezekiel said, I'm going to white Jesus. You what? Not the one that just said this? When you read when you read the second Ezra, chapter 13, he talked about the man that came up out of the water. That they was on, he was standing up on the mountain. He came down with 10,000 of his holy one. They explained him in there again. That's for witnesses. See, my whole point is
We have come into the knowledge of the truth. Knowledge of the what?
Truth.
Knowledge of the what?
Truth.
We came into the knowledge of the truth, not the knowledge of a lie. Satan speak lies. We got to live truth.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So we ain't going to start feeling funny in our heart like, well, why we got to talk about Jesus? We're going to talk about Jesus. We're going to talk about everything that's a lie. Right?
Yes, sir.
We're going to talk about everything that's a lie because these children got to know.
That's right.
You got to know. So you walk around here, half, your heart half in getting a present for Christmas, your half heart in not getting. Come on. You know it. So when I first came to the truth, I still wanted my flesh along with Christmas. I was like... Then I remember my granddaddy called, well, should we give him something for Christmas? I'm like, well, yeah, tell him to give him something for Christmas, but just give it to him the next day. You know what I'm saying? 1 foot in, what?
One foot
out. Feel me? Because I believe it's doing more effect now because they people see us. I seen Gabby cousin at the bank the other day. Nah, I ain't did nothing special. I don't know if she know we was in an accident or not. She seen me in the truck. She looked like, well, how y'all doing? So we doing real good. We doing real good. I know she's thinking, hey, but I know that they was in that coat. They don't come around. I don't know what she was thinking about. Hey, you gotta be a light, right? Come on, let's read.
And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot, and girded about the paps with a golden girdle. His head and his hairs were white like wool, and white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if they were burnt in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters.
All right, now watch this. Come up here, bud. Watch this. How do Jesus look, bud? Right there, tell him on camera. What does that look like?
Well, like wool.
Wool, white like wool. What does skin look like, bud?
Burnished brass.
Burnished brass. See, I haven't seen bud. See, bud got on the camera to tell you because you got to understand. We all got to be able to confess that Jesus is Lord, right? We can't change it around. Every knee, what?
Shall bow.
And every tongue shall what?
Amen.
So we ain't going to confess about no fake Jesus. So my whole point, tell me, when we went to Word Revival, go back to that picture, brother. This is who I was worshiping.
Right.
And I didn't mind.
Sure,
I didn't care. It didn't matter. I came. Well, oh well. We run in there every week. Say, Jesus look like Pastor Gray, don't he? All that healing he doing, we doing right. And we didn't care.
That's right.
Have a problem. I was all over James. What was James' name? James Copain. We was all over their house, you know what I mean? Sitting up laughing and giggling and everything. Having fun, having a ball, nothing. See, I've never been that person. I ain't a skin person. I ain't tripping on skin. I never trip on skin. Because either I'm gonna be able to look in your eyes and know who you are, and we're going to find out who that person is.
Right.
And that's who we deal with. I ain't never just went and star somebody, you white. People's crazy, man. I'm just telling y'all because this is part of the deception that Satan has got this race stuff going on. If y'all ain't figured it out yet, we brothers and sisters in here, man. You ain't gonna bring all that deception to us. Lying to people talking about these folks is Edomite, they ain't getting in the kingdom. Man, these folks, y'all going to hell for that wicked stuff. Because Christ said, speak, preach the gospel to every creature.
Yes, sir.
How you know what you mix with?
Hallelujah.
You don't know what you mix with, just running around talking. These folks are out of their mind. I'm telling you, we ain't going to receive no deception. Let's go. Right. More lies. Let's read this. I got one for this.
Christianity began with the ministry of Jesus Christ.
Now look. You see this? It said Christianity began what?
The ministry of Jesus Christ.
Now did we just get through reading that the Father said that this would have been spoke of since the beginning?
Yes, sir.
Christ was just a part of the coming. And nowhere in the part of the coming did they talk about Christianity. Just what I'm trying to tell you. You got to show this video to y'all people, man. Let them do what they're going to do with it. I take it. Let them curse me out at the bottom of the page. I got something for them because they curse me out. I ain't going to be like this, well, let me plead. I ain't going to plead. Hey, put your number on. I'll call you. I'll call you. Straight up. And let's figure out. Let's figure this out real quick. All right? Finish reading, brother.
Which began when he was around 30 years old in the first century A.D. The birthplace of Christianity was Levant, which is known in modern times as Israel and Palestine.
Now, y'all believe that?
No, sir.
Y'all receive that as your truth? No, sir. As your Lord and Savior?
No.
Is that what you want?
No,
sir. Right. We truly know that this ministry and the covenant is on to Israel, which foreigners, and it should be, and strangers can join themselves to. All right, go. All right. Israelites of the past. Now, these is drawings. That was on the wall that people have took snapshots of. Now, who you think these people is with these things on their head?
Egyptians,
ain't it?
Yep.
Who you think them people are? Yes. We know the Hebrews, they were getting their butt whooped sitting down on their floor. Now, let's go pull up one of them Jesus movies. Right? It ain't gonna be them.
No.
That's what I mean. But people is constantly because, you know what? Y'all said be ye transformed by the renewing of what?
Your
by your mind. You gotta erase this out of your mind and deal with this thing like it is so you can understand the whole of the matter. This is a matter that's been going on earth that y'all know that this folk, these people have been living a lie. Zondervan Bible Dictionary said that Ham, the son of Noah, is the progenitor of all the black races, of all the dark races, except who?
Negroes.
Now, what makes Zondervan say that? It's a distinction because he pointing something out that, see, this is his. See, you can't reach people that work at the school I was teaching at Friday. You can't reach them. Why? Because they don't know this. They don't know this. They run around stealing. I mean, just acting a fool. You got an adult in the room. You cursing. And the dude, he asked this girl, are you going to suck my thing?
Oh, my God.
I said, hey, boy. Oh, my bad. I said, you didn't know I was standing? You didn't know I was here? What do your teacher do? He won't say that when the teacher, I say it out in the hall. You sure do. See, this is acceptable behavior. This is what's going on. You don't realize. And these kids are graduating every year. We're putting this type of product out in the communities. That don't have knowledge of Christ, don't have knowledge of the lies and deception, don't know, they don't care if Jesus is black or white, they don't care if the sky is green or blue. They don't care. You got all of this hopelessness going on, and guess what? I guarantee you the Father ain't happy about it. Ain't happy about it because somebody got to be an example. Let's go, brother. Alright, look at this. What did that say, Brother Miguel?
They left black. When he was asked about peace in the Middle East, the late president of Egypt, Gamal Abdel Nasser, stated, the Jews will never be able to live in peace, live here in peace, because they left here black but came back white.
Now, y'all hear this? Y'all see this? See, these are just lies that just keep going. Lies that keep going. I got to point this out to you. Why? Because now, understanding that we Israel, you're going to understand that what the main point that I'm going to point out at the end. Because Yah is drawing people from all nations and creeds that's going to be Israel.
Yes, sir.
Why? Because Israel that left was disobedient.
No.
He gave them a bill of divorce.
That's right.
And everybody that's coming back is coming back on the contingent of receiving the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And them are sons and daughters. That's why he said, if you are only sons and daughters in the flesh, you're none of his. Because he give everybody that got the spirit is his.
That's right.
Everybody that got the spirit
is his.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. See what I'm saying? So that's why you ain't fooling me with Hebrew Israeliteism and all this other stuff. Because I can guarantee you, I know who'll go to bat for me. Well, Brother Bud will go to bat for me. And I go to bat for him because I've seen it. He ain't got to show me nothing else.
Hallelujah.
I ain't know him from a hole in the wall. He showed up at that house. I said, boy, he looked like he backwood. Then I went to his house. Yep, he backwood. We drove all the way up to Iowa. I mean, just driving there. We had no signal. I mean, it was just, like, where we at, man? We over here. Then we rode on that street. And I see all this stuff in Bud's yard. I said, then there was like one more house. I said, man, I don't know if we in the right. Then Bud was standing in the door. I said, all right. Bud, I ain't never been out there nothing like that. But I'm doing it, bro. I'm doing it. What a father. You understand?
Hallelujah.
And it's good, brother, because it's just the love, brother. You don't understand the love I have for it. Can't no Hebrew Israelite on no video, nobody change the love I have for you, brother. Because I see the Father has truly put his hand upon you to work for the kingdom. Hallelujah. You can't replace that, man. That's how you know who it is, because we become one family that's going to accomplish many and mighty things in you. And it ain't got nothing to do with it. See, people want to start this color thing, all this. Look, I'm just looking at the election. Look at Donald Trump and all this other stuff.
Yeah.
See, I'm not worried about none of that stuff, man.
That's right.
Well, I'm going to be fine doing with what the Messiah said do until he returns.
That's right.
Laying on hands. Right?
Yes, sir.
Casting out devil.
That's right.
Preaching that the kingdom of heaven is near. What I'm doing. Let's go. All right. Here they go. This is what he was talking about right here. Jews of Israel 2016. There you go. Give him a hand. There you go. All right. All right, here we go. Israel of the covenant. Israel of the covenant. This is for us. I want y'all to listen to this real good because. Yeah, we got a few more slides. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. About 5 more slides after this. We're about to be done. All right, let's read this. This is Israel of the covenant. This is what's all encompassing. This is where we all come into this. This is where we begin to help each other out. This is where we get a chance to enjoy the kingdom. Because your righteousness that's going to be stored up in Shemaim and the jewels that's added to your crown is because we go forth and understand this stuff that's wrote right here. All right? Even this and the other screen, because we're talking about some things that make sense. Now, let's hear. Let's go. Mark 13:24-27.
But in those days, after that tribulation, the sun shall be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars of heaven shall fall, and the powers that are in heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. And then shall he send his angels, and shall gather together his elect from the four winds.
Now pause. Let me tell you how they trick us, Brother Bud. We said we should look up in the clouds and see who coming. The Son of Man, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now y'all remember this? Look up. It's a bird. Right. It's a plane. Mm-hmm. It's who?
It's Superman.
Superman.
Wow.
Right?
Yeah.
Come on, man. Y'all ain't been paying attention. Y'all been sleeping.
Yep.
Come on.
His elect from the four winds.
Now wait a minute. See, you here. Listen what he's saying. The signs is gonna come. Then you're gonna see the Messiah coming in, and then he's gonna send out his angels to do what?
Gather
his elect from where?
From
the four corners. So what you doing in Israel right now? What you doing over there?
Too early.
Way early, ain't it? What y'all doing? Because look, this he said he going to gather them from what? When you can see him, right?
Okay.
I'm just going what's in the word. I ain't make this up. So Kim, it's right there. Right? Come on.
From the uttermost part of the earth to the uttermost part of heaven.
Right? Y'all got that? So that's a prominent time for Israel getting gathered together. Okay? Isaiah 11:11-14.
And it shall be, in that day, Yahweh sets his hand again, a second time, to recover the remnant of his people who are left from Ashur, and from Egypt, and from Patros, and from Cush, from Elam, and from Shinar, from Hamath, and from the islands of the sea. And he shall raise a banner for the nations, and gather the outcasts of Israel, and assemble the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth. And the envy of Ephraim shall turn aside, and the adversaries of Judah be cut off. Ephraim shall not envy Judah, and Judah not trouble Ephraim.
Now, let me tell you what I said. Let me tell you what I was talking about that day when Christ came back. Because then I goes over to Isaiah chapter 11. Then this says, in that day. So I'm starting to see a pattern that in this day it seems like people getting gathered up.
Right.
The people that's close and the people that's in the uttermost parts of the earth is getting gathered up. But yet, it's still people in the land right now. Looking at scrolls. Right? This is saying something else. Let's go to Ezekiel and see what Ezekiel says.
Therefore say, thus saith Yahweh Elohim, I will even gather you from the people and assemble you out of the countries which ye have been scattered, and I will give you the land of Israel.
Now look what he said. He said, even I will gather you. He said, who's going to gather?
I will.
So then if I go back to other verses, it seems like that's what Christ was coming in to do, to gather his people. And people was gathered. They were being gathered from the uttermost parts of the earth when he came back. So I'm just looking at this. It ain't hard to put together is when you read this. So you got to make this stuff make sense. What you doing in the land right now? I ought to go do this stand right there at the board. What y'all doing? What y'all doing over here? Right? Oh, I know what you've been there. You've been there. You know what I mean? 70 AD came in. Boy, y'all been holding it down. Holding it down. Let's go. Isaiah 56:3-5.
And let not the son of the foreigner who has joined himself to Yahweh speak, saying, Yahweh has certainly separated me from his people.
Now stop. Do not let the foreigner who has joined himself to his people say what?
That he has separated me from his people.
That he has separated me from his people. See, so this is what happened. When you come up with this mystery religion. Right? Come on.
Nor let the eunuch say, look, I am a dry tree. For thus says Yahweh to the eunuchs, who guard my Sabbaths and have chosen what pleases me, and are holding on to my covenant, to tell them, I shall give in my house and within my walls a place and a name better than that of sons and daughters.
Here it is. This was strange. He said he's going to give a name for them. A memorial. Just like he did with Cornelius.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Cornelius prayed. Cornelius of the Italian band has a name better than sons and daughters. Just like it said right there. Because people missing it. You focus on what people told you to focus. They told you to start focusing on how people look and distinguish. And then you fall into, you come into the knowledge of the truth, and then you take that seed from Satan and start standing on the corner cursing out certain races of people. You fool. Well, I'm saying, we just missed the whole move of the Spirit. Let's go. Mark 16:15-16.
And he said unto them, go ye into the world, all the world, and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believes and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believes not shall be damned.
Simple as that. Simple as that, right? Mm-hmm. All right. Restoring the body to Yah. Let's go. Saints, here's the truth. Here's the truth. We who have come to know the truth shall go forth by doing the wonderful works that shed light on darkness. See, that's all I do. And so that leads us to, as we come down to these last slides, that leads us to why we led to do what we're going to do. See, you got to understand. You heard something today that is being planted in you as a seed, so you can begin to understand why you're doing it. Or maybe some of y'all forgot. You just started calling yourself Israel, and then you forgot what this whole truth thing was about. So now that we come together under this pretext and under this premise of working in the kingdom, we got to show forth power today. You can't be too tired.
Yes,
sir. See, I may be tired. I can't wait to lay in.
Hallelujah.
Because you gotta let the Father do what he's going to do. Don't leave here without getting some type of prayer, man, so that y'all can give you a testimony. Because you're going to have a testimony of him. And you're going to have to keep his command.
Hallelujah.
Right?
Yes, sir.
All right. Guess who that shall be? It shall be all those who shall repent for the remission of their sins and be filled with the Holy Spirit. And these who shall be filled with the Holy Spirit shall go about doing those things in which the Spirit directs them to do. All right? Bringing glory to the name of Yah. All right. Let's go. All right. Praise Yah, Israel. We are called to do. We can find all of these things out. All right? That's it. Let's read it.
Hallelujah.
All right. Matthew chapter 10. 7 and 8. This is what we call to do, saints. See this, brother? This is just a study in itself, right? These scriptures right here. Sitting down and looking at this. Because when you come up on people that say they are of Christ, they are walking in the faith, then you're going to have to evaluate them towards. No, they ain't doing it. Who got Matthew? Let's go, brother.
And as you go, proclaim, saying, the reign of the heavens has drawn near. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out demons. You have received without paying, give without being paid.
You see that? See, some of y'all ain't staying unless you get paid. You got a couple dollars. I'll stay helping you deliver. Look, man, this is what we got to do, didn't it? Didn't I just tell you, preach that the kingdom of heaven, and that's why I said, brother, hey, look, next day, brother, let's pray. Let's do this. Mm-mm. Let's pray, you and your family. Let's all pray, man, and lay hands and let y'all lead us. I couldn't wait till you came, Brother Curtis, because I knew. I said, man, start planting in there, boom. So now I see where we at. We're going to usher in this healing.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Right? Let's go. 1 Timothy chapter 5.
Rebuke not an elder, but entreat him as a father, the younger men as brethren, the elder women as mothers, the younger as sisters.
Now, Paul, I got a question, brother, before we get this far. You can do this at home by yourself, can't you?
No, sir.
You can't sit at home and have elders, just fake elders around the house that you ain't supposed to rebuke? You see this item? Come on.
With all purity, honor widows that are widows indeed. But if any widow have children or nephews, let them learn first to show piety at home and to requite their parents, for that is good and acceptable before Yah. Now she that is a widow indeed and desolate, trusteth in Yah, and continueth in supplications and prayers night and day. But she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. and these things give in charge, that they might be blameless. But if any provide
now, not... wait a minute, bro. You said them things give in charge. So that means us as a body, as we operate, this is what we do amongst each other. But some kind of way we can do that by ourselves at home, though, right? Is it?
No.
See, that's what I'm trying to tell people. See, this is just, I'm saying it because this is related to just different things that's out there that, you know, people just think they can just get to the kingdom without serving one another. You can't serve me just because the computer screen touch, watching my videos and saying, you know what, brother, bless you. I'm. Do you need something, bro? Need a cup of water? They gonna go across TV screen. I need to see you give it to me in my dang old hand, bro. You know what I'm saying? So I'm discerning what spirit you gave it to me. Here. Right? Come on, brother. Let's go.
But if any provide not for his own, especially for those of his own house, he had denied the faith and is worse than an infidel. And worse than an infidel. Let not a widow be taken into the number under 80 years old, having been the wife of one man, reported of for good works. If she have brought up children, if she have lodged strangers, if she have washed the saints' feet, if she have relieved the afflicted, if she have diligently followed every good work. But the younger widows refuse, and when they have begun to wax wanton against Christ, they were married, having damnation because they have cast off their first faith. And withal, they learn to be idle, wandering about from house to house, and not only idle, but tattlers, also and busybodies, speaking things which they ought not. I would therefore that the younger women marry, bear children, guard the house, give none occasion to the adversary to speak reproachfully. For some are already turned aside after Satan. And any man or woman that believeth have widows, let them relieve them, and let not the church be charged, that it may relieve them that are widows indeed. Let the elders that rule well be counted worthy of double honor, especially they who labor in the word and doctrine. For the scripture saith, thou shalt not muzzle the ox that treadeth out the corn, and the laborer is worthy of his reward. Against an elder, receive not an accusation, but before two or three witnesses. Them that sin, rebuke before all, and others might also fear. I charge thee before Yah, and Yahweh Jesus Christ, and the elect angels, that thou observe these things without preferring one before another. Do nothing by partiality. Lay hands suddenly on no man, neither be partaker of another man's sins. Keep thyself pure. Drink no longer water, but use a little wine for thy stomach's sake and thy often infirmities. Some men's sins are open beforehand, going before to judgment, and some men they follow after. Likewise also, the good works of some are manifest beforehand, and that are otherwise cannot be hid.
Now, you can rebuke the elder from home, though, can't you? Okay. You can. And if you ain't supposed to be drinking alcoholic drinks, then why they said drink wine? You see, I'm going to say all of this, all of these lies, that's not the truth. See, it's things that's presented to show that he read the whole Timothy because we're supposed to be together. That's it. I mean, I got to go. Colossians 2, 6 through 10. Go ahead.
Therefore, as you accept the Messiah, Jesus, the Master, walk in him, having been rooted and built up in him, and established in belief, as you were taught, overflowing in it with thanksgiving. See to it that no one makes a prey of you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the tradition of men, according to the elementary matters of the world, and not according to Messiah. Because in him dwells all completeness of Elohimness, bodily. And you have been made complete in him who is the head of all principality and authority.
Right, 2 Timothy. Let's go, brother. So make sure I read it out.
2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 14 through 17.
Let's go.
But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them, and that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation.
Now stop. He said continue in the holy scriptures.
Yes, sir.
Do y'all know what the scriptures is? Mm-hmm. Luke, Matthew, Mark, John.
No.
No.
No,
those are what? You got the Gospels, you got the Acts of the Apostles, and then you have the letters. The scriptures is back the other way, where people don't want to go.
Come on.
And Paul told Timothy, who knew Christ died, that the law was supposed to be had done away with, to continue in what? The Holy Scriptures. Because it's able to do what? Make thee wise. And what?
Salvation.
Make you wise unto salvation. That's what we're striving for, right? Let's go.
Through faith, which is in Christ Jesus, all scripture is given by inspiration of Yah, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction, and righteousness, that the man of Yah may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works.
You see, this is what Paul told him. This is why we use this. This is why we use the Torah. This is why we use the scriptures. So that a man of y'all can be what? Yes, sir. Come on, you got it. Let's go. Let's get these last one. Let's go. John 14. Well, we read John 14 today. Let's go to Revelations 14, 12. Y'all out there on YouTube, you read John 14, 12 through 17 yourself. We went through it already. Let's go.
Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of Yah and the faith of Jesus.
All right. All right, we sleep over here. Last screen says Shabbat Shalom. I don't know what's going on over there. All right, there it is. All right. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Right. Did we learn something?
Yes, sir.
I didn't mean to bore y'all. But y'all is good. And we got to get the understanding of what we're doing. Did you know all of this stuff, my sister? Oh my goodness. You see, because it's an eye opener. It's good that we know that we traveling along something, because what happens, and this is what I found, even in my relationship with, you know, meeting Pastor Fox, when we first went up to start fellowship with Pastor Fox, same thing. We went all the way out to, I guess it's Round Prairie. Was it Colony, Kansas? I don't know where it's at.
Oh,
yeah, we went out there and same thing, man. We got right in day one in fellowship, because now I'm understanding that Yah is a spirit, and if we have his same spirit, that we're going to fellowship and serve as a body, as one people, to try to strive and keep each other feet from the fire and get to this kingdom. And the more people we have that's on the right path, not coming to cause strife, man, the sweeter this walk gets, because now we build a community. We build a lifestyle. We teach our children in the ways of the Most High Yah. And Yah comes and visits us. He comes and bless. He shows us that he's with us by the works that he do through our hands, the healings, the deliverance, and all those things. And this is what we are to do.
preaching that the kingdom of heaven is near. And it ain't all this other stuff. But you still want leeks and garlics, right? When you came out of Egypt, you still want long for all this stuff. But you got to let it go. Because you got to come out from among them and be what?
Separate.
Be ye separate. Hallelujah. You all out there on YouTube, we pray that you be blessed. I'm Pastor Corey here with Straightway Kansas City. These are the saints of the Most High Yah. We hope that you learned something. We hope that you take this word to heart, that you're able to begin to find fellowship where you are and draw near to the Most High Yah, that you put your hands to this work, to what we are all required to do. And do not get associated and caught up in doctrine of men and traditions of men, because it's a lie and it's going to lead you to the path of destruction, and that destruction leads to death. Shabbat shalom.